Alright, so we've taken a look at adult animation from Japan, the United States, and Canada. So now it's time to take a look at Europe and their contributions to the adult animation legacy. You could argue that I'm stretching it by calling these adult animated films. Most of these are technically rated PG, but I feel they carry enough mature themes and imagery to be considered for adults. Also, keep in mind I'm talking about animation aimed at adult audiences, and not straight up porn. So if you're looking for stuff like Snow White and the Seven Perverts, this is not the right place to be. So hold on to your tea and crumpets as we jump into my top 5 European adult animated films. Number 5. Plague Dogs. Based on the novel by Richard Adams, this watercolor film starts with the drowning of a dog. Nope, not doing it. Number 5. Wallace and Gromit. It doesn't matter which one. Every version of the stop-motion buddy comedy is hilarious, and it doesn't involve any drowning animals. Wait, what are you doing with that sheep? I guess if you give it a chance. Plague Dogs does have a very biting commentary on how we treat animals, as we follow two dogs who escape from an extremely cruel animal testing facility and attempt to survive the European countryside. The friendship between the pair feels very organic, which makes the cruelty that man and nature inflicts upon them all the more heart-wrenching. I'm calling this one a tie because you're going to need some Wallace and Gromit after seeing Plague Dogs. Number 4, Animal Farm. Based on the novel by George Orwell, Animal Farm follows the story of animals on a farm. Okay, well, the animals are allegories for Russian politicians and societal classes. We follow the revolt against a corrupt farmer, only to learn that absolute power corrupts absolutely, as we witness the farm's attempts to run itself. For a film made in 1954, the animation holds up amazingly, though at a glance one would think they were watching a cartoon for children and not a propaganda piece. While not 100% accurate to the book, this adaptation treats the source material with respect and hits almost all the main points of the plot, but with an altered ending that reflects the mentality of its creators.
Number 3. La Planète Sauvage.
What the fuck? What is that even? Did that thing just... Ew. Once I got over the initial reaction, I found that the film actually has a pretty profound story about a human baby on a fantastic planet who is adopted by a giant blue alien species known as Draugs. It grants a window into a strange world full of very unique creatures where humans are treated as pests and follows their eventual uprising against their alien overlords. Based on the French novel Hommes en Série by Stéphane Wool, the animation and soundtrack very much has an early 70s feel to it, but for all its lacking in fluidity and polish, is made up for in sheer creativity and strangeness.
Number 2. Philidae.
Much like Animal Farm, the first impression of this film might lead you to believe that you're watching something aimed at children, and also like Animal Farm, it's based on a novel, this time by Akif Parisny. Unlike that film, however, it doesn't take long to see that this is a gritty, gruesome, and violent murder mystery film from the perspective of cats. We follow a cat named Francis as he attempts to solve a series of related cat murders in the neighborhood. Being from 1994, this is the best-looking film in the list, and it holds its own against other mystery thriller films in general.
Number 1. Watership Down.
Based on the novel by Richard Adams, Watership Down follows a group of rabbits as they leave their warren and face the dangers of both nature and man as they search for a new home. While seemingly a cartoon aimed at children, this film has some dark turns as it takes us through the lives of these nomadic bunnies and the perils they face. While you can draw some very clear parallels between Watership Down and the Plague Dogs due to sharing an author, Watership Down is a lot more watchable and a lot less emotionally draining than Plague Dogs. This film displays some very complex themes, encouraging the viewer to consider their own definitions of home and family, along with the characters. It's very easy to feel connected to these timeless characters and their plight. So those are my favorite adult animated films from across the Atlantic. I know for sure I missed a few good ones, so let me know which ones I should check out. Once again, this was Fade Dragon Tear. Thanks for watching. Peace out.